Hello, I'm Philip Stoughton from ID People. I'm here at Wise Media's 6th EMEA Summit in Abu Dhabi, and I'm joined by Ruth Annis, who is with the Ministry of Interior from Estonia. Ruth, thank you for joining me again. I listened with interest to your presentation, and there are a couple of interesting points that came out for me. One of them was the issue of responsibility as a state. If you issue someone with an identity, you're responsible for that identity, and I think it's a point that hasn't been made enough, that as a state, we do have to take responsibility for who we identify. Can you expand on that a bit?
Yes, I think that maybe really the state's responsibility on the identification of the population has been underestimated, because the aim of identification is to avoid duplicates, to avoid fraudulent use of identity. So when a state has already confirmed person's identity, the state has to take responsibility that that person can't have another identity, at least not within that country. Mm-hmm. The identity could be a wrong one, but at least it is the only one the person can have.
Okay, and that really affects how you operate with other states, because by nature of their identification, they're then taking that abroad with them, so it has to be a trusted document.
Yes, as international migration is constantly growing, and in the globalizing world, people don't stay in the country. Mm. It is very important that other states can trust the identity of that person. In reality, it can happen that people have one identity in one country and another identity in another country. Mm. That, for example, has happened in asylum system.
Okay.
When people apply asylum under different names in different countries. So that's why if we have already a secure identity system, and the more countries have it, the better the result will be.
Mm. Okay, that kind of connects into another thing I wanted to talk about, which was interoperability. And someone asked the question about that on a European basis, but it is really a global issue, isn't it? It's only if all these systems work together that we can really be successful.
Yes, definitely. Europe is just one part of the world, but in the globalizing world and the market, it's also global, it's international.
Mm.
So we definitely have to look further than just European Union countries. I think that the more trusted systems are created by other countries in other parts of the world, the most profitable things can come out of it for people.
Yeah, and if you think of what Estonia have achieved as almost a gold standard in the industry, and many people do refer to it as that, who does one then look to make sure everybody else can bring their standards up to something similar, something that can be accepted by everybody?
Well, currently, it's just mutual agreements between the states. It would be a huge step further if the states would collect the same data, the same kind of data, and of the same quality.
Mm.
This doesn't need many international agreements. It just needs the awareness and the purposeful acts from the governments.
Yeah, so some desire, some momentum behind it. Absolutely. Okay, and the last thing I wanted to touch on, one of the things you mentioned in an ID system is keep it simple, keep it convenient. Convenience from a point of view of the user, but simplicity so they can understand it and trust it, I suppose.
Yes, this is another key factor. One thing is that you have to make the people trust the system, and the other thing is that regular people must use it. It must be really simple and user-friendly, and it can't be time-consuming.
Mm.
If the system is complicated, it can be as trustworthy as you ever can create, but people just won't use it.
Yeah, if it's too cumbersome.
Yes,
yeah.
If it's not convenient.
Yeah, and moving forward, I assume Estonia Estonia will continue to drive this smart government, this whole process. One of the things you mentioned as a development phase is mobile ID actually in the SIM card of the mobile device. Is that something you see as a key enabler, since I guess so many of your citizens, like most citizens, have mobile devices?
Yes, I see that the mobile device definitely is a future, and also a tablet, of course, because with mobile ID you can identify yourself and give digital signature from any part of the world. But with a card, ID card, you need a card reader either installed in a computer or just a separate one. So in future, I think more and more services will be provided through the mobile phone, and it is common. It can used from any part of the world. It can used on practically any mobile device.
So
I think it's the future.
Yeah. Ruth, thank you very much for your time. Thanks for chatting to me again. Look forward to next time, where I'm sure there'll be even more new developments in Estonia. Thank you.
Thank you so much.